Hi, I am here with Gidget, the itty bitty Yorkie. She is 9 months old and this is her first haircut. I have absolutely no idea how she's going to handle this. So let's get busy and see how she does. All right, Gidget, you ready for this? So she looks like the type of Yorkie who has had low blood sugar in the past. Many times I see puppies who have gone through several bouts of low blood sugar end up with this type of coat for a while. Eventually it usually comes in pretty good. She's got like a thick wiry undercoat on her ears, so I'm gonna stay at a 10 blade length. It's okay, I'm not gonna hurt you. Good girl. That's it. It's okay. Just taking off the top third of the ear. Good girl. Come here. This is all new for you, isn't it? Stay. Good girl. Stay. I'm going to attempt to just get the corners of the eyes. Good girl. It's okay. That's going to be a little too scary for her, so I'm going to skip that. And she has been spayed. And you can see she's missing hair on her front leg from the spay. I'll bring you in a little closer because she's so tiny. I'm going to do under her tail with a 7. I'll go to a 40 for her pads. Go ahead and put her on the harness for this because I don't know if she's going to get a little jumpy for that. No, I don't. Good girl. I have to make it small enough for you. There. Now you're safe. Good girl, Gidget. So the reason why I do a 7 under the tail is about one in every, I don't know, 100 dogs may be a little sensitive under the tail, which causes them to sit down over and over again after being groomed. So by leaving a bit more hair, I'm avoiding that possibility. And I have some client dogs that even a 7 is too short.
That wasn't so bad at all. Good girl. See, you're just fine. You're just fine, right? Yeah. It's not bad.
Take the harness off for just a minute while I set the length on her top. And then I'll put it back on. So, as you can see, she's quite ratty. What I'm going to do I'm going to comb the hair up. And snip it off all the way down our top line. For me personally, using combs on something like this would take more time than it's worth, and you'd still have to go back and scissor it. So I'm just gonna do it equally all the way down. Owner said she wanted to keep the tail. She likes the tail. So I don't want her too wispy looking. She's a tiny little thing to begin with. So now I'm just going to go in and do the underline. Match it up on the other side. And even though she's missing hair here, I'm going to try to keep the legs pretty full. So I'm just going to take off the wispy stuff.
Like, what are you doing to me? I don't know you. I don't know what this is. And we have rain outside, and I'm scared. Stay.
So she's got some wispy stuff on her sides, but I don't want to cut it short, so I'm just going to pull it up in the comb, up to the top line, just take it off up there. If she will stand still for this. Stay. Good girl, give her a break and some praise. All right, back to work. Back to work. I try not to get puppies too excited because it's hard to get them back. But you also have to give them a release for the angst. I think the biggest problem groomers run into with this kind of hair is they try to get it perfect. The idea is not perfection. It's not perfectly even. It's tidy. It's all people want is tidy. Holding still enough to hold my comb there, it'll be best. Good girl. and put the harness back on so I can have more freedom with the rest of her. Not having to hold on to her. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. So I don't know if you can see in here, this is all still really wispy, but when it's laying down, it looks pretty good. So we're not going to try to go in there and perfect that because then we'll lose too much coat and she will look extremely scrawny. It gave me the freedom to do what I wanted. So I'm just doing it like I would if she were my own, trying to encourage good coat growth. Let's try to get in around these eyes. It's a good girl, it's okay. Not gonna hurt you. So I'm gonna put a hook on her to keep her from popping up. It's not her crying. There's a little dog in the back that just got dropped off that is pining for its owner. That's very good. gonna do the top of her head the same way as the body. Pull it all up, snip it. Her back up for this. It's just safer for her. If they can't pop up, it's less chance of injuring her. When I first created this harness, I called it the Anchor Pet Grooming Harness for this purpose. Because it anchors them from this popping up action. And it keeps all the pressure off the throat. Keeps it firmly behind the dog's shoulder blades, or at the shoulder blades. It's where all the pressure goes. And here, there's complete looseness. Which is extremely important for a little Yorkie.
Right? It's extreme.
Use thinning shears to blend the lines of the ear into the longer hair. Little tangle right here.
Got it.
Okay, come here.
That was dramatic. I know it was dramatic. I know it was so sad. I know. Oh my goodness.
So it's really important when you're training them to be groomed to allow them to have a release.
What is that thing on you? Huh? What is it? You're very sweet. I like you a lot. Don't have to worry.
So now I'm going to come in around the edges if I can with thinning shears. Try to soften all this up. People would think the little itty bitty ones would be super easy, but they're not. Let me put a bow on you. I made an itty bitty little bow for her. An itty bitty one. Yeah. Got an itty bitty bow for an itty bitty dog. So I'm going to go ahead and hook her up for this. Just to keep her still. So she's not all over the place. It's super important when you put a bow in to always take your comb, slide it between the skull and the bow. Make sure it slides all the way through. Never want to have any skin caught up in there. So for me personally, the idea is to get a nice lay of coat, not take them too short, get rid of all the stragglies, give them that cute little puppy look. So by doing these things I'm doing with my hands, it's teaching her how to stack or stand. Because as I move forward with her, I'm going to want her to stand four square. So I need her to get used to those hand motions.